In this video, I'll demonstrate how to access data from an OST Outlook profile file using the OST to PST converter software from Stellar. As you may know, you cannot open the OST files unless you use specialized tools such as the Stellar tool. So here is how you use this tool. So if I go here to Outlook, and this does not have much information at this point because I'm using it for demonstration purposes. If I go here to File and then go under Account Settings, go to Account Settings, and then here is my file. Go to Data Files. We can click here on File Location, and this is where the data is actually stored. To back up this file, I could simply copy it, and I would have to close Microsoft Outlook. And then if I go back here to Documents, this is where I saved this earlier. So if I want to open this, if I go to Outlook, I can't, because this is an OST file. You can open only PST files in Microsoft Outlook. So if I click here and go to Outlook Files, notice nothing shows up. However, if I choose to show all files, here is my OST file. And if I try to open it, it will not allow me to open it. So here is where the tool comes into play, a tool like the one from Stellar. So if you go to stellarinfo.com, and I'll have the link for the download in the description as well, and I'll go ahead and install it. As soon as you open this, it will prompt you to list the profiles or choose one manually. In my case, I'll choose to list the profiles, and notice it has identified my profile currently in Outlook. If you want to have a copy of your OST profile for backup purposes, you can simply select Convert here, and it will save your online profile to a PST file in your computer. And then I can click here on Save the converted file, choose a location for that file.
And that was the process to back up your Outlook profile for an existing account that is fully functional, but you want to have a copy of the emails in your local computer. Now, in this next example, I'm going to show you how to open an OST file from another account that you may have backed up, but you want to make that available, let's say contacts from it or other components of that Outlook file. Once we open the Stellar converter for OST, and this is the licensed version of the software, we click on Select Outlook File, and then I'll choose Manually. Now I'll go ahead and browse for the file, and here is the OST file. So we click on Open, click on Convert. Depending on how large the file size is, it will take a little time. But in most cases, it's pretty quick, as you can see here. Now, if you wanted to preview certain components of this, you can simply go here, for example, to calendar entries. Or if you wanted to check only the contacts, notice it will display whatever contacts are as part of that profile. If we wanted to go ahead, save this file and convert this to a PST file for offline access or backup purposes, we click here on Save the Converted File, select PST, and then click on Next. Then it's prompting us where we want to save it. Then click here OK. Now here we have also directions on how to import the PST file. And the way you do that is by opening Microsoft Outlook. And now I can bring this file in two ways. I can go under File and choose Open and Export, and then select Import and Export, and then import from another program or file, and then select the PST file. This allows us to import only certain components if we wanted. For example, the lost contacts, next, and then next again. Select the file where to import it from, press Next, and then if you expand this and select only contacts, press Finish, and I go here to Contacts. Notice it brought in only those particular contacts. Now, the other way to import the file or to open that backed up file is by going under File and then choose Open or Export, And instead of using import-export, we simply open a data file. So in this case, it allows us to access everything in that PST file. So we click here on Open Outlook File, and then we go to the folder where we saved the converted file, and then click on Open, Open again, and it should put it as another profile down here. And then it can click on it, and we'd be able to access all the emails as part of that profile, and all the outbox emails and tests and all that type of stuff, including the contacts and everything else that are part of this PST file.
If you like this video, please press like, subscribe, and then click on the bell icon.